Statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom. Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition.
Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit.
It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation for when you don't. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth.
And the wealth of those who care about and love you.
It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition. Welcome to the show.
Guy's good, isn't he? Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Great to be with you. Hope you're having a good day. Start to your day. You're out of the blocks. At the sound of the gun, you weren't too late and you weren't too early. Because, then we got to start over. You know how they do in the races. You are listening to Let's Talk Nutrition. Sometimes people just happen to be fooling around with the dial on the radio and they come across the show and they don't know what they're listening to. So that's why I always tell you what you're listening to. You're listening to Let's Talk Nutrition. We're here Monday through Friday, a couple of hours. It's a good way to spend some time. Don't expect you to stay the entire two, but if you do, that's good. And have an in-studio guest today. Excuse the expression, he's live. I don't know why they always say that. What do you think he is? He's in studio. He's in live. He's live. No, he's on videotape. Of course he's live. Hamilton, he's never been on the show before. Not that I recall. If he was on the show before, then I have a memory issue. Because when I walked down to the front of the building to pick him up, as I walked in, I didn't recognize him. So, first-time guest. We'll make sure that Hamilton is going to have a good time. Hope you have a good time, too. The show is about edutainment. This is not one of those painful health talk shows where people talk in code, can't understand what they're talking about, and we don't do Mother Teresa around here. That is, no diagnosing and treating on the radio. That doesn't go on. Can't do that. Shouldn't do that. But that doesn't mean you can't call with a health issue, and we can talk about it. And you might have this health issue that Hamilton wants to focus on today, and haven't talked too much about it on the show over the past 10 years. Have talked about food allergies, but have not talked about food intolerance or food intolerances too much. Been alluded to, danced around, pointed at. But so this will be good. And there's a difference between allergies and intolerances. You'll see. And maybe you suffer from a food intolerance and don't even know it. We'll see what Hamilton has to say about that. This is what he works for Enzymedica. He's a educator for Enzymedica. They're a new sponsor to Let's Talk Nutrition. I always tell people who the sponsors are. You need to know who the sponsors are. And in fact, today is the start of the LTN logo contest. So if you go to the LTN Facebook page, on there, can you pull that up, Josh? If you're watching, Josh will pull up the page, and you'll see it on your screen. You'll see a logo. Now, to enter the contest, you have to like the page. So you do that. That's the first thing. Find it? You did. And then you look at the logo and you try to name the company. Now I'm going to tell you a secret. Don't tell anybody I told you. Here's the way to do this. If you go to the Let's Talk Nutrition Facebook page, there's a link there that says our sponsors. Check out that link because I want you to win. Check out the link and you'll see, you'll be able to identify the sponsors. They'll give you the name of the sponsor and they'll give you an image of the logo. So don't tell anybody I told you. And you'll win a prize. The prize is a full supplement product from the company, whether that's Enzymedica, whoever it may be. Who's the logo for today? Anybody know? We'll see. And there's a lot of logo information on that page. I'm looking at it as Josh is pulling it up. What is that? Some sort of fried food there? Quiona chicken nugget recipe? Really? Okay. Nevertheless, so stay tuned. There's a number you can call, too, 877-897-8255. Oh, and by the way, you send the message on that Facebook page using the Facebook message system, and you name the company. Okay? We're in business. 877-897-8255 is a toll-free number wherever, however you may be listening or watching the show, and whatever you may be doing. There was a story trending this morning. It caught my attention. I've reported on this phenomenon before. This deals with the issue of parents not recognizing that their child or children is or are obese or overweight. You say, how can that be? I've reported on this a number of times. And there's a substantial amount of research to support the notion that sometimes parents may be in denial about their child's health. So in the New York Times, at their newyorktimes.com, their health section, they had a story was entitled Parents' Denial Fuels Childhood Obesity Epidemic. So they opened the story with talking about the 16-year-old boy. He was 60 pounds overweight. That's a lot of weight. And they also had some labs done, a blood test. And the blood test indicated that he had fatty liver disease. This boy's 16 years old now. Fatty liver disease is typically an adult disease. Typically. Not all the time, but typically. So his mother took him to a pediatric weight management clinic in New Haven, Connecticut. So the dietitian working at the clinic gave her some advice. Yes, the child's mother didn't like the advice. And she says to the nurse, quote, I can't believe you're telling me I can't buy Chips Ahoy cookies. I laugh because you can't make that up. What are you serious? You got a child that's 60 pounds overweight, madam, and the child's sitting there, and you're saying to the dietitian, I can't buy Chip Ahoy cookies. No, you can't. The name of the lady, they gave her name in the story. Mary Savoye. Apparently, they said in the story, exasperated the dietitian who recalled this exchange, had counseled parents who seem unable to acknowledge the harsh truth about their child's weight, they said. And this is what that was the clinician, Mary Savoy. She said, often they don't want to accept it because change means a lot of work for everyone, including themselves, close quote. Yeah, that means you're going to have to change the way you eat because what's being made at home for the dinner. You think, oh, we're going to make an unhealthy meal for me and the father and the husband, and we'll make a healthy meal for the children or the child. No, it doesn't work that way. One meal, everybody eats it. They've done studies where the child is either overweight or obese, and the parents say, my child is not overweight or obese. And they're looking at the child every single day.
Exclusively from Natural Factors.
Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Murray. I'm very excited to have the opportunity to talk with you about PGX, a truly revolutionary natural product that works perfectly to help get at the core issues that make weight loss so difficult. PGX is a clinically proven way to help people to achieve their ideal body weight that is safe and natural. PGX leads to a dramatic reduction in the glycemic index of any food or meal. It also ultimately causes the release of compounds that achieve two important goals in weight loss. One, telling your brain that you're satisfied so you eat less, and two, improving the action of the hormone insulin. If you've ever tried to lose weight and failed, it's not your fault. You just need the tremendous support that PGX can provide. For more information on making your weight loss dream a near effortless reality, please go to PGX.com.
Are you able to consume the recommended 6 to 8 servings of fresh fruits and vegetables in a day for optimal health and well-being? Who has time to prepare and eat that many servings? Now there is a way to consume 5 whole servings of fresh fruits and vegetables in an easy-to-mix drink. That's half of your daily recommended servings in one drink. Introducing Greens Plus Wild Berry Burst Powder, made up of 29 enzymatically alive whole foods, along with 7 antioxidant-rich berry extracts in a delicious powder form that you can easily mix into water or your favorite fruit juice. Greens Plus Wild Berry Burst contains sea vegetables, probiotics, organic grasses, and herbal extracts that help to support the immune system, providing increased energy, provide an alkaline pH, and cleanse and detoxify the body. No heat is used in the processing of Greens Plus Wild Berry Burst, so it is enzymatically alive, just like fresh fruits and vegetables. You can find Greens Plus Wild Berry Burst at your local health food store. Ask for it by name.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss, or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted Best Independent Chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine, Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
Are you waking up each day to the life you have to live or to the life you want to live? Better health shouldn't be left to chance. Smart choices to living longer and stronger include making Kyolic Aged Garlic Extract a part of your daily routine. For years, medical researchers have recommended adding Kyolic to the diet as a powerful tool to enhancing overall heart and immune health. Recent clinical studies at UCLA Medical Center using Kyolic suggest that garlic may slow plaque formation in the arteries and support healthy cholesterol and homocysteine levels. Previous research also shows Kyolic may enhance your immune system defenses. Kyolic is organic, odorless, and the only antioxidant garlic supplement available worldwide. Maintaining a healthier you could extend your life. Your wellness begins with Kyolic Aged Garlic Extract, available everywhere fine nutritional supplements are sold. Visit Kyolic.com, that's Kyolic.com, or call 1-800-421-2998 for a free sample today.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Nutrix Hawaii. More nutrition, better health, purely Hawaiian. Now Foods, our products work. Garden of Life, empowering extraordinary health. Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace. Now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Flexin, the joint health experts. North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis. Nordic Naturals, pure and great tasting omega oils. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Well, I'm glad you're here, and I'm glad I'm here too. And Hamilton Cavanella is going to be my guest today. He's a first-time guest on Let's Talk Nutrition. I was just talking with him off air a little bit. Nice guy, and he has something very smart too. Has something to talk about today that we haven't talked much about around here. We've alluded to it. We've danced around it. We've talked about a companion concept called allergies, food allergies, but we have not talked about food intolerance or food intolerances. We have not talked about food intolerances. Yeah, that'll turn your mic on, Hamilton. The red button. And this will be good. This is a new theme, relatively speaking, on the show. Want to develop it, we'll take our time. We're in no hurry. Hamilton drove an hour and 45 minutes to get here, so we're not gonna give him the bum's rush, and we're going to take our time with him. Now, I was telling you about this story about the parent, the mom, that brings her 16-year-old, 60-pound overweight child into the dietitian. What I didn't tell you about the mom, and the mom says to the dietitian, you know, what do you mean? I'm paraphrasing. What do you mean I can't buy Chip Ahoy cookies anymore? You want to know what the mother does for a living? If you had to guess, what do you think she does for a living? She's a nurse. Yeah, I tell you, if I sat up all night trying to make some of this stuff up every day, somebody asked me, I get to ask this question a lot. This was just asked of me not too long ago. Dr. Garko, do you make that stuff up on the show? I say, no, that's why I keep saying I can't make this up. No, I don't make it up. The woman's a nurse. I wonder what she looks like. I wonder if she's overweight or obese. Have you ever gone to Disney World, Disneyland, or one of those theme parks? Just take a moment, sit down on a bench where people are walking by, and take a look at the families. When you see the mom and dad that are a little, you know, overweight or obese, maybe, or even obese, the child typically is on the pathway to that as well. They all look alike. So, because they're all eating. Oh, yeah, I see that. If you're watching, what did you do there? You made him a little fatter? Is that what you did?
No.
You need to talk on a mic if you're going to talk to me.
No, that's the image they had in the article.
I thought maybe you had done some shadowing. No. Inside his tummy are Chip Ahoy cookies. Yeah. See his tummy? Poor thing. I mean, come on. The lady's a nurse. Dr. Katz, I know Dr. Katz, David Katz. He's director of Yale. He's been on my show. Yale's Prevention Research Center has coined a term for this problem where parents are oblivious to the child's overweight problem. He calls it obliv-obesity. Dr. Katz. Dr. Katz says, quote, parents can't ignore the threat of obesity to our children and still hope to fix it, close quote. He's right. Another expert chimed in. I have parents tell me they waited to address it, meaning the overweight problem with the child, because they thought their child would grow out of their extra weight. No, they're going to grow into extra weight. You keep feeding them, you know, food high in salt, sugar, and fat, the fast food, processed food. I wonder if there's any connection between these processed foods and food intolerances. I'm going to ask Hamilton that today. And you might be surprised as to these differences between a food allergies and food intolerances. You're going to be surprised. Some people just make some assumptions about food intolerances, and they sort of throw it into the same health arena or category as allergies. They're related. They're related, but they're different. They're different concepts. 877-897-8255. 877-897-TALK. As I said, my guest is Hamilton. See if I can pronounce his last name. I asked him three times. Cabanella. That's a nice name. Hamilton Cabanella, educator for Enzymedica. Very good company. Been around a long time. Enzymes, you know. Well, you get a little hint here. Maybe enzymes have something to do with food intolerances. Maybe they can help. We'll see. So, Hamilton, welcome to the show. And what do you make of the nurse mom with the 16-year-old son who's 60 pounds overweight and says to the dietitian with a straight face, "What do you mean I can't buy Chip Ahoy cookies?" What do you make of that, Hamilton?
It's a sad epidemic that's happening, unfortunately.
It's everywhere.
Yeah.
It's everywhere. Not only in the United States, but across the world. And it happens, Hamilton, where they import, in a lot of places, where they import the Western way of eating, whether that's in the United States or some places in Europe. That Western-style diet, when it's imported into these countries,
they go from fit to fat.
They go from...
like that.
Overnight. Fit to fat, and from, you know, some of these cultures have been around for hundreds and thousands of years, and they were doing just fine. Then all of a sudden, boom goes the dynamite, and you find processed food dominating the food culture. We'll see if there's a connection between these food intolerances and these in this current trend.
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement, or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation, so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
Over the past 60 years, I have prescribed and been introduced to countless health therapies from around the world. I formulated MediCe Plus, a natural remedy with high amounts of vitamin C and lysine for maintaining strong bones, cartilage, teeth, and gums, and aiding in collagen formation. Now in my 90s, MediCe Plus is my insurance for the maintenance of good health. Make MediCe Plus a part of your daily health routine, too.
Available at health food stores and specialty pharmacies.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering, you're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Renew Life, the digestive care company, Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing, Greens Plus, superfood for super health, MediC Plus, for heart health and more, New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom, NeoCell, the true science of collagen, Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition, wherever and however you may be listening, whatever you may be doing while you're listening or watching the show. You can watch the show at letstalknutrition.com. There's a like a TV screen there. Just click on that, refresh it, especially if you're using Internet Explorer. My guest is with an educator with Enzymedica, and Hamilton is the first time it's the first time he's been on the show. Hamilton Cabanella. And Hamilton, welcome again to the show. This business about food allergies, food intolerances, there's a bit of confusion around all that. So we'll take our time today and sort through it. And there's a lot to, you know, as I was preparing for the show today, there's a lot here. I mean, this is a topic that can be addressed in a number of different shows, for that matter, to cover the territory. And there may be people listening that they think they have a food allergy, and it may not be. It may be a food intolerance, and they may think they have a food intolerance, and it could be a food allergy, and they could be doing the wrong things. Isn't that right? Yeah, you need to turn your mic on. Get that mic into your...
That is right, Doc.
Okay. So maybe one place to start would be in... and I saw a number of different definitions this morning as I was preparing operational definitions for food intolerance. How do you define a food intolerance?
Well, it's generally, simplest definition would be that the person lacks the right enzymes to digest a certain food substrate. So because they have that lack of the proper enzyme, it triggers, you know, all kinds of different symptoms, whether it's, you know, digestive, whether it's, you know, a runny nose, whatever the case may be. But that would be the simplest definition. Not having the right worker or the right enzyme can't digest that particular substrate properly, and along comes the problem.
Okay, so by substrate, I mean, look, there are three macronutrients, protein, carbohydrate, and fat. That would be a substrate.
Correct.
Also, we have vitamins and minerals that we can take, right?
Right.
Like in a supplement form. Can those serve as a substrate?
Generally, the vitamins and minerals are usually in their simplest form. So usually when we're taking, you know, a supplement in vitamin C, it doesn't need further breakdown. So they're really, you know, wouldn't fall into an intolerance saying I'm intolerant to vitamin C or I'm intolerant to such and such mineral. Generally, they're in their simplest form, so your body's going to utilize it. If you do too much of it, yes, you know, you can fall into some trouble, even something as safe as vitamin C. But generally, those kind of don't fall under food intolerance. It's much more a specific, for example, the dairy sugar is probably the one we are most familiar with, lactose. Dairy sugar, lactose intolerance, and it's simply that, not having the enzyme to break down that substrate.
Any number of definitions I saw this morning. Some were intelligible, some were unintelligible. One way they talked about it generally when I started to look at all these different definitions, you know, sort of a theme that came up was simply the body's inability to digest some food, a particular food. Right. Correct. Would that be still in the realm of correctness here?
Absolutely.
All right. When your body cannot completely process a food, that could be a protein, a carbohydrate, or a fat, right?
Correct.
Okay. And people don't sometimes understand, and if you could expand on this, that many of the foods that we eat today are new foods, relatively speaking, in our evolutionary history. Isn't that right?
Absolutely. And really, since I would say the Industrial Revolution, where foods were being delivered in mass quantities, kind of that preservative system began. It wasn't local produce or local foods. That kind of sent, you know, our overall food as a planet kind of down the drain. So that's affected a lot. Things have been engineered to survive, you know, on a shelf, to survive the travel, to survive, you know, basically sometimes months or sadly even years sitting there and expect us to properly digest it and absorb some kind of nutrients.
There's no way for us to confirm or disconfirm a hypothesis that would say, or address the issue of our ancient ancestors suffered from food intolerance. I don't know how we would confirm or disconfirm that. If you had to guess, prior to the agricultural industrial revolution, if you want to call it that, agriculture, prior to the dawn of agriculture, do you think our ancient ancestors suffered from food intolerance?
I think at a lesser degree, because actually I was reading something the other day where it talked about gluten sensitivity. Back in the Greek days around the first century, there was a term, which I can't remember it right now, it was in Greek, but they feel it may have been mentioning a gluten sensitivity.
The way they were describing it?
Yes.
The symptoms, it sounded like gluten insensitivity?
Absolutely. And that's kind of where the word, it kind of derived into what celiac is. So it kind of derived from that Greek word, what we call celiac disease now.
Yes.
So there may have been, but definitely not to the extent we see it today.
So it's in an ironic sense. You had hunter-gatherers, right? And they dominated prior to the agriculture, the dawn of agriculture. That's the way it was done. Hunted and gathered. Hunted game, gathered berries, whatever, nuts, seeds, whatever you could gather, roots, the eight root plants, whatever. That's what humans did. Then somehow agriculture got invented, right? And then no longer did people have to roam and wander around the place, if you will, on the earth. They could stay in one place, grow crops. That seemed like a miracle in some ways, and has benefited society and cultures around the world for hundreds and hundreds of years. But it also brought some side effects, didn't it?
Apparently, my friend.
So, you're on TV today, and I could have given you my makeup kit, but I didn't do that. And so you have people at home that are somebody that is watching, maybe? Like, you're married? Are you married?
Yeah, I am married.
You are married. Congratulations.
Thank you.
What's your wife's? May I ask your wife's first name?
Sure, Jay Lee.
Jay Lee. Mm-hmm. All right, so we have to get her to watch, and see, she can see you on TV today. And I should tell her, if she is watching now or listening, that these shows are on demand, so she can never, now she can always use this as blackmail, because she can have a copy of this show anytime she wants. So you better, as we say in incorrect English, you better do good. Jay Lee, hope you're watching.
At Country Life Vitamins, we've been helping people live happy, healthy lives since 1971, and we believe integrity should always be our number one ingredient. We are committed to this belief because you deserve high-quality nutrition, specifically crafted with the highest standards to support your health. Country Life's manufacturing facility is an NSF GMP-registered facility, as well as USDA-certified organic, so you can feel good about the products you're taking. Country Life Vitamins is also the first supplement company in the United States to have a complete line of products certified gluten-free. That's over 500 products. Country Life Vitamins' pledge of integrity is based on five standards: authenticity, cleanliness, freshness, consistency, and accuracy. Ask for Country Life's top-selling products, such as Coenzyme B Advanced for increased energy or FlexAble for joint health. Country Life Vitamins' commitment to ensure all of our products are pure, wholesome, gluten-free supplements full of natural goodness provides peace of mind with the knowledge you are using a brand you can trust.
Feeling tired after your meal? Occasional gas, bloating, or indigestion at inopportune times? You may have an enzyme deficiency. Did you know that many common digestive discomforts can be caused by poor digestion? When food isn't completely digested, it begins to ferment in the digestive tract, which may cause uncomfortable symptoms. Digest Gold, America's number one selling enzyme product, offers unparalleled support for your digestive needs. It contains exclusive blends of enzymes optimized to be 3 times stronger and work more than 6 times faster than other leading digestive supplements. With just 1 capsule per meal, Digest Gold offers support to break down carbohydrates, fats, fiber, and protein. Enzymedica products are all natural, vegetarian, contain absolutely no fillers, and are vegan and kosher when possible. You'll find Digest Gold and other Enzymedica products at fine health food stores near you. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Still looking for your fountain of youth? It's Zennia. Look no further than the beauty aisle of your favorite health and nutrition store. Zennia is the newest product from Form Essentials, the brand that brought you Solace. So you know it's filled with the highest quality ingredients. Many cosmetic products only treat topically, while Zennia addresses aging and hair loss from within. Formulated to support the growth of radiant hair, skin, and nails, Zennia is sure to help you turn back the hands of time and assist you in aging gracefully. Zennia provides a spectrum of key vitamins and other evidence-based natural ingredients, such as alpha-lipoic acid, biotin, collagen, and elastin peptides, all combined in one capsule for your convenience. By promoting beauty from the inside out, you are strengthening your cells and creating a lasting enhancement to your natural beauty. Zennia fits into your daily routine and can be taken to boost your current cosmetic products. Available now at leading health and nutrition stores. Ask for Zennia by name. Start taking Zennia hair, skin, and nails today, and get ready to look amazing.
MediC Plus. The C in MediC Plus stands for vitamin C, and the plus stands for lysine. Did you know vitamin C is arguably the most important water-soluble antioxidant in the human body? Or that we cannot produce vitamin C on our own like animals do? We need MediC Plus to meet our daily needs. MediC Plus provides the body with a high concentration of vitamin C and lysine, which work together to build collagen for optimal heart health. Dr. Gifford Jones, graduate of the Harvard Medical School, developed MediC Plus after his own heart attack 16 years ago. With the help of MediC Plus, Dr. Gifford Jones is now a healthy 91 years old. But MediC Plus is not just for heart health. MediC Plus also benefits your immune system, vision, promotes healthy skin, provides support for healthy teeth and gums, healthy joints, and much more. So make MediC Plus part of your daily routine and enjoy healthy living. MediC Plus at your local vitamin discount center and all fine health food stores. You can also order online at mymedi-c.com or call toll free at 1-844-871-0069.
Is your fish oil wildly pure? New Chapter is proud to offer a whole food approach to fish oil, Whole Mega. Naturally pure 100% wild-caught salmon comes from the pristine waters of Alaska. Like extra virgin olive oil, the fresh-caught salmon for Whole Mega is pressed immediately after harvest. And that's all that's needed to deliver wild Alaskan salmon's whole complement of vital omega fatty acids. These omegas support your heart health. One serving of Whole Mega per day, 2 grams, has been clinically shown to help retain healthy triglyceride levels and to improve the omega-3 index, a studied marker of heart health. And did you know experts recommend consuming 2 to 3 servings of fish per week? So 1 week of Whole Mega delivers the omegas of 3 servings of wild Alaskan salmon. Discover the New Chapter difference, wildly pure Whole Mega. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Available at your local fine health food store.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Canavest, from seed to shelf. Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition. Kyolic, aging makes the finest garlic truly odorless. Jaro Formulas, superior nutrition and formulation. Natural Factors, where great health begins. NZ Medica, the enzyme experts. Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
And we're back, and welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. My guest is Hamilton Cavanella, and we're talking about food intolerances, not to be confused with food allergies. So a food allergy is different from a food intolerance, Hamilton. How?
When we talk about a true food allergy, we're talking about an immune reaction to a food. Mm-hmm. So it really is not dependent on how well we digested it. It simply is a reaction. That is a bad guy to your body. Very common, for example, shellfish. There is no amount no amount of chewing.
Right.
You simply need to stay away from
it. My mom had terrible allergic reaction to shellfish.
And that's the only treatment. Stay away from the shellfish.
Yeah, otherwise you're gonna have it. In other words, the immune system recognizes that substrate, that food. The substrate is a... That's what they say in the business, is a food, that food as an enemy to the body. It's a foreign agent, if you will.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Food intolerance doesn't implicate the immune system in that way.
No, it is generally just a digestive reaction. Again, not breaking down that food properly. It can trigger immune reactions. You know, it can trigger, again, leaky gut, particles start leaking into the bloodstream. Then your immune system goes, hey, what is that's entered the bloodstream? You know, what is this strange substance?
Right.
And it can react.
Sure.
But it doesn't begin that way, not at
because
all.
Because when the lining of your intestine, your small intestine, when that becomes permeable, which you don't want it to be, you can get particles, elements, leaking out of the intestine into the bloodstream. The digestive system is supposed to be a self-contained system. It's not supposed to interact with the rest of the body directly. And so when things start to leak into the bloodstream, the immune system, vigilant, recognizes it could be proteins, it could be anything, and says, this doesn't belong here, I need to attack it, get rid of it.
Correct.
That's an allergy. Food intolerance is a whole nother dietary creature, right? Now, true or false, food intolerance is inherited.
There can be genetic propensities. For example, again, we'll go back to the most common one, lactose intolerance. Mm. In our genetics, after the age of two, there is code where the amount of lactase, the enzyme we produce to digest lactose, reduces. Different cultures, it's been shown, the amount that it drops down to is greater than in others. So there is a genetic setup to that.
All right.
But not as grave as sometimes we make it out. Well, it's my genes. It's the way I am. Not that severe.
Because I read a couple of articles. They were talking about this, and they were talking about that the food insensitivity, your reaction, this sort of negative reaction to the food, we'll talk about how it manifests itself here in a moment, was sort of built into the genes. They were talking about in this one piece. They said, and I'll quote them, they said, it runs in the family, all in the family, so to speak. You can get it from your parents, your grandparents. If you have children, you've already, they were saying in this piece, that you've already passed this food intolerance on to your youngsters. Celiac disease or gluten sensitivity, they cited that as an instance. They said occurs in 10% of all first-degree relatives of celiacs. Sisters, brothers, parents, and children. Okay. The same food sensitivities. This is a question. Have you observed and talked with people where the same food sensitivity will appear in the same family? Have you seen that?
Yes. And part of the connection sometimes isn't as much genetic, in my humble point of view. Sometimes is that families tend to eat
the same things.
So just like the child with the Chips Ahoy, you know, as an example, probably the whole family eats Chips Ahoy. And that's what starts happening. They start overindulging sometimes in a certain food. Mm-hmm. So the whole family's going to develop that sensitivity.
True or false? Food intolerance is common.
Very true.
More so than, you think it's underestimated, underpredicted, underdiagnosed?
Absolutely.
Do you think it's misdiagnosed?
In many cases, yes.
You think it's misdiagnosed for allergies when it's not? Do you think that's happening?
I think mainstream medicine is starting to realize there's such a thing as intolerance, but previously, you know, for many years, no, there was no such a thing.
I was reading another article where they talked about lactose intolerance. I don't know. This seemed like a high number to me, a high percentage, about approximately 75% of the population with lactose intolerance
have some kind, not as severe, maybe not as
a
person that
that's
we may
lot,
know.
Hamilton.
It is great amount of population. Again, not as severe. Some people have a spoonful of milk and are running to the bathroom. Maybe not that severe, but some type of discomfort. Those are the numbers.
Wow. And that's because they were born without the lactase, that enzyme, to digest the lactose.
Well, they may have been born with it, but again, it's kind of nature's way of telling us that after the age of two or three, we should stop drinking milk, especially
so they
another animal's milk. You know, not even our own mothers, another animal's that was meant for the baby cow.
Yes.
Hey, why don't we drink
there
that?
Are some people that... There are, I know, I've met them. I've talked with them. Boy, and they're passionate about this. We have no business eating dairy. We have no business doing that. And they said, drinking milk? Why are we doing that? So are you saying to me you can have the enzyme lactase but still be lactose intolerant?
Because it's going to drop. Again, the amount that we're producing up to the age of two or three, very high. After that age, it absolutely reduces. For some, to a very low amount where it affects you. For some of us, you know, we can get away with some of it.
But. So what happens is the lactose doesn't get digested, goes into the large intestine, and the bacteria say, oh, yummy. And they start to feast on the, and they That's where you get the gas, absolutely, the bloating. For them, that's a picnic. Right?
Absolutely.
This is a picnic for the bacteria in your large intestine. For you, it's panic and pain, right?
Gas, bloating,
embarrassing, terrible, uncomfortable.
Absolutely.
Food is your friend. Food can be your enemy. It just depends. Your relationship with food. Sometimes the nature of the relationship is not within the span of your influence, only to say that there are some foods probably you can't eat and should thus stay away from those foods. This is a very interesting topic. I really like this. This is a lot to learn. We'll come back. We'll tell you more.
statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom.
Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition.
Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit.
It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation for when you don't. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth.
And the wealth of those who care about and love you.
It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition. Welcome to the show.
Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Great to be with you. Thanks for tuning in, stopping by, or you just fumbled your way across the dial and found us. I don't care how you got here. Stick around. You may learn something or hear about something that could make a difference in your health. Today, we're talking with Hamilton Carbonella. I'm doing this from memory. I'm not even looking at any notes or papers. Hamilton Carbonella. And he was kind enough to drive all the way over from Venice, Florida, into the studio. And we appreciate that. And consequently, you were able to see him on the streaming of the show at letstalknutrition.com. You see, he's a nice looking guy and knows a lot about nutrition, enzymes, people's relationship with food. This issue of food intolerance, big topic. We're going to devote, since Enzymedica is sponsoring one of the sponsors of the show, we're going to have an opportunity to talk more about this going forward. This is a great opportunity for all of us to learn more. I need to learn more about food intolerances. There's always something to learn, always room for improvement. And you may have a question about food intolerance or food allergies, whatever. Call, don't hesitate, 877-897-8255, 877-897-TALK. You heard me make the announcement that today is the start of the LTN logo contest, and it is. That logo will be posted at 11 o'clock, I'm told, at the office, because we had some folks call in. They went there to find the logo, and it wasn't there yet, but they'll have it up at 11 today. And here's how you enter this contest. You go to the LTN Facebook page. When you get there, you'll see the LTN logo message. You have to like the page. Like the page. That's how you officially enter. Then name the logo in a message with using the Facebook system, and then you'll win a prize if you get it right. Now, as I said in the first portion of the show, this is what I would recommend you do. If you're not sure about that, because I want you to win, go to the LTN Facebook page at letstalknutrition.com. Or just the website, excuse me, the Let's Talk Nutrition website. When you get to the website, there's a link that says Our Sponsors. Big clue. Click on that, and you'll see all the sponsors with their name and logo. Then go back to the LTN Facebook page, and then you'll have the answer. I'm trying to help you out because I want you to win. And you'll win a prize. You'll win a full product, whatever company that is that day. Every Tuesday and Thursday, we'll do this. And they will have the logo up there at 11 today, they tell me, at the office. Okay? This is fun. We'll do this all summer. So, food intolerances. Boy, I'll tell you. When I started getting into the literature this morning on this, it's a robust literature. And dietitians, nutritionists, people interested in health generally, MDs, they've been writing and talking about this for a long time. Hamilton, I found an article. It was written in 1979 by Robert Herman and Lewis Hagler. Both were doctors. It was entitled Food Intolerance in Humans. It's published in a publication called Symposium on Clinical Nutrition. I'm holding that up. And even though it was written in 79, as I went through the piece, I found that even though it was that's dated. I mean, this were you even born in 79?
I was.
Were you? Barely. It still seemed relevant. They were talking, these guys had it right. These two doctors seemed to have most of it pretty right. And I was using this morning to sort of enrich my understanding. And I thought, well, gee, this is pretty dated. Let me read some other things that are more current. And I'm thinking, not much has changed. And I mean, we know more about these food intolerances. One of the things that kept coming up was the issue of misdiagnosis. That kept coming up when I was reading this morning, misdiagnosing food intolerance for food allergies. What are some of the signs and symptoms of a food intolerance?
The problem sometimes with misdiagnosing is that the symptoms can be similar. I mean, obviously, the most common one is going to be abdominal discomfort or abdominal pain. But from there, the most common ones are foggy brain, rashes or eczema in the skin, fatigue, headaches as migraines.
Sounds like allergies so far.
Correct. Very closely mimic joint pain.
Gas and bloating.
Depression. Absolutely. And all of them mimic, again, like you said, a food allergy. But one of the major differences between food allergies and such is the severity and how quick a food allergy occurs. Food allergy, when you eat, for example, the shellfish or a peanut.
Doesn't take long?
You're probably still in finishing that dinner where they're going to have to rush you to an ER and your throat is closing, etc. With a food intolerance, in many cases, it's delayed. That's one of kind
by
of
how
that
much?
Ballpark.
What would be a...
Sometimes hours, sometimes even days. So that's one of the easier ways to kind of get an idea. Is it an allergy or is it an intolerance?
Do people have a food intolerance for some particular food or foods and don't realize it and continue to eat the foods? They could do this for months or even years. Does that happen?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think the nation, as a country, I think it's happening to many of us. We think a certain symptom that we're having, anything from a migraine to, you know, being achy or you know, your thoughts not being very clear, et cetera, we sometimes go down so many other paths of medicine or changes in our life, but it could be the food we're eating.
And this goes something to the way people relate to food. If you like a particular food, let me do it this way. I always talk about relationship with food. You could have a relationship with somebody, and it may not be a healthy relationship. They may not be good for you, but you stay in the relationship anyway, right?
Absolutely.
People do the same thing with food. They eat a particular food. They have an unhealthy relationship with that food, but they continue to eat it anyway.
It's funny you mentioned that in a lecture a while ago from a naturopath. He was speaking about that, how it becomes kind of a vicious cycle of eating the trigger food. And at first, it'll give us a bit of a high. We feel better. Like somebody that says, well, I can't go without my cup of coffee in the morning, or I need to have, you know, a piece of this every day. They get a high, but then they have a reaction later, and then they suffer, they don't feel well, etc. But their brain still remembers the high. So I still want a piece of this, or I want just a bite of that, even though you're going to suffer later. And it kind of just becomes a vicious cycle.
Or they hope that maybe I can eat it this time and I won't have a reaction.
Maybe.
So that's an interesting analogy, I think. Just as with people, we have an unhealthy relationship with people, but we continue to have those relationships with different individuals. Same with food and our relationship with food. It may not be good for us, but we continue to want to eat it. Wow. Well, the nature of human nature. And relationship with food is very complicated. Yes, there's biology involved, no question. Chemistry is involved. Nutrients are chemicals, I understand. But the psycho-emotional connection? Chemicals be damned, I'm going to eat it anyway. Right? I'm going to eat it anyway. I don't care if they make me sick. I'm going to date that woman anywhere. I'm going to date that man anyway. I don't care if they're not good for me. I'm going to, yeah, see? That's how it gets so complicated. You try to help people, sometimes it's not so easy. Easy to lay it out, difficult to carry it out. Enzymes, we come back. Enzymedica knows a thing or two about enzymes. Maybe this can help with the food intolerances. We'll go into that now.
Did you know your digestive tract is home to millions of bacteria? Some good, some not so good. And if you want to stay healthy, it's important to make sure that your body is populated with the good bacteria it needs. Probiotic Defense contains 13 of today's most effective friendly bacteria strains, along with other compounds shown in studies to support healthy digestion and immune system function. Don't settle for low potency, overpriced formulas. Ask for Now Foods Probiotic Defense with the bright orange label. To find a retailer near you, go to nowfoods.com.
What are you doing this month? If you suffer from stiff joints, you can do something special. You could try new FlexNow joint formula. FlexNow offers you complete relief in just 1 month or a complete refund. FlexNow is a unique concentration of shea nut triterpenes, the most potent inflammation fighter of any botanical. And it's only when inflammation is reduced that your body begins to heal. Try new FlexNow joint formula and make this the month you get rid of stiff joints. Ask for FlexNow at Vitamin Discount Center and other leading natural product stores.
Hi, I'm Jordan Rubin, founder and CEO of Garden of Life. Oceans 3 was created with a simple premise in mind. Develop a line of premium omega-3 fish oil formulations that met or exceeded the market leader in quality. And then go beyond omega-3 by providing amplified benefits and value to the consumer. Oceans 3 contains ultra-pure, high-potency fish oil, along with astaxanthin and fucoxanthin. Each of these ingredients, when taken individually, have superb benefits. When they are combined into the exciting compound omega-xanthin, they work synergistically to amplify their already amazing benefits. In addition to the synergy of omega-xanthin, Oceans 3 offers unrivaled purity and greater value than the leading omega-3 fish oils available today, making the Oceans 3 family of products the best choice for anyone looking to add a healthy dose of omega-3 fats and a giant dose of extraordinary health to their lives.
Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Murray with a minute of important health news. One of my all-time favorite natural products is a special extract of licorice known as DGL. DGL is short for deglycyrrhizinated licorice, but I tell my patients that it stands for darn good licorice. DGL is made by removing the compound in licorice that can raise blood pressure in some people. Double-blind clinical studies have shown DGL is quite useful in healing stomach and intestinal ulcers. In fact, in head-to-head studies, it has actually outperformed popular anti-ulcer drugs. But rather than inhibit the release of stomach acid, DGL stimulates the normal defense mechanisms that prevent ulcer formation and promote healing. Clinical studies have not only shown DGL to be extremely effective, but also that it is completely without side effects. Clearly, DGL is a better choice.
The ever-increasing stress and toxicity we are exposed to from our environment, diets, and lifestyles make internal cleansing a necessary part of a good health regimen. Founded in 1980, Yerba Prima was the first company to launch a whole-body internal cleansing kit. Since that time, they have continued to develop and manufacture a complete range of all-natural, high-quality fiber and internal cleansing products. By using all-natural psyllium fiber and no harmful stimulant laxatives, all Yerba Prima fiber and internal cleansing products can be used over a long period of time to ensure optimal health and regularity. With nearly 30 years dedicated to all-natural cleansing products, it's easy to see why Yerba Prima is a leader in the fiber and cleansing products category. Learn more at yerbaprima.com, Y-E-R-B-A-P-R-I-M-A.com, or visit your local health retailer. Yerba Prima, pioneer in internal cleansing products.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Nutrix Hawaii. More nutrition, better health, purely Hawaiian. Now Foods, our products work. Garden of Life, empowering extraordinary health. Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace. Now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Flexin, the joint health experts. North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis. Nordic Naturals, pure and great tasting omega oils. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Food intolerance, sometimes it's plural. Food intolerances, you could be intolerant to more than one food. I was talking off air with my guest, Hamilton Cavanella. He's an educator for Enzymedica. And we were talking about this business of our relationship with food. And he was telling me, well, why don't you tell me what you were telling? Tell the audience what you were telling me about these receptor sites, the opiate receptor sites and so on.
Absolutely. We work a lot as a company with the autism community. We actually founded a nonprofit organization, so we have a bit of, you know, connection with them. And we see in many cases these children, when they're being kind of their diet is changing and they're being taken away from gluten, how their behavior, how their tantrums become almost like somebody in drug rehab. And it's because one of the proteins in gluten has been known to kind of serve kind of like a puzzle piece. It fits in an opiate receptor in our brains. And we see it a little more maybe obvious in the case of the autism community. But I think it may be happening in more of us than we know, maybe at a lesser degree, but I think it may still be triggering certain behavioral factors in a lot of us.
Mm-hmm. And the reason why we started talking about this was because I mentioned to Hamilton that I said sometimes, like in our relational life with people, we are into a relationship and it's not healthy for us, but we stay in it. We do the same thing with food. The food is not good for us in that it causes us to have all these terrible symptoms, but we eat it anyway. We're intolerant to the food. We have a food intolerance for some particular food or foods, but we continue to eat it anyway. And I was reminded of alcohol. People will drink alcohol to excess, and even though that they're going to have a hangover and get sick and whatever, they'll do it anyway, and they'll not do it one time, but they'll do it habitually. And of course, an alcoholic would be an extreme example, but you get my point. So this relationship with food is complicated. Nevertheless, if you had a food intolerance, let's say it's lactose intolerance, you can have a carbohydrate. There could be a particular carbohydrate that for which you have an intolerance, or a particular protein for which you have whey protein, for example. Some people can't eat whey protein, and they have all kinds of symptoms when they eat whey protein. So it can be with any particular category of food, protein, carbohydrate, or fat, and then some particular food within that category or macronutrient category. And you heard Hamilton mention that enzymes become important here. So let's say that, let's say whey protein. I know many people that can't eat whey protein. Would there be a way for them to take enzymes and still eat the whey protein?
Absolutely.
Really?
You can. And again, barring that it's an allergy, which in the many...
That it's not an allergy.
Correct. It's not an allergy. Taking the right enzyme, in the case of that, it would be a protease. Proteases break down proteins. This being a type of protein, by taking the right type of protease, yeah, you break it down to its simple amino acid. You're breaking down, again, I usually illustrate a protein kind of like a pearl necklace. You're breaking down the little links, and it's going to be individual little pearls. Once that's done, you don't have the reaction.
Hmm. And you take enzymes typically before, during, or after a meal?
We recommend before.
How much time? How long? How much before a meal?
Our capsules are a vegetarian capsule that open very quickly, 30 seconds, 45 seconds. So
You
could basically swallow the capsule and begin eating.
Wow. So you don't have to wait 20 minutes or anything like that?
Not at all.
Now, you don't have to have a food intolerance. In fact, you may serve yourself Let me ask you this. As people age, as they move deeper into the life cycle, have you all found, does the research support the notion that their enzymatic potential, if you will, starts to decline? Does that happen?
Absolutely. And our company was kind of founded on a book, if you will, by Dr. Howell, which is called Enzyme Nutrition, very well-known book kind of in our industry. And that's one of his foundations. You know, as we age, you know, it's shown in animal models, human models, our capacity to produce enzymes starts reducing. You know, not only we see it more obvious in our digestive capabilities, mm-hmm. but it happens everywhere else. Our immune system, healing and injury, you know, everywhere, you know, but it's just more obvious in our digestive capacity.
Yeah, the obvious sometimes escapes us. And that is aging. The nature of aging is that systems start to lose their full functional capacity. That's the nature of aging. That's nature's agenda. Immune system goes haywire, right? Digestive system, not quite the same, so on and so on. Little by little, incrementally, as you move through the life cycle. Now, prevention, slowing things down. We talk a lot about that around here, and I'm a big fan, big believer, and I know it works. I'm not the only one. There's a boxcars of studies to support my position. This is an easy position to support. So when we come back, we'll talk about some specific products from Enzymedica. I have a number of people that I've worked with and have recommended to them to try taking enzymes, and they report to me, this is anecdotal, this is not a clinical double-blind placebo-controlled trial, they report to me far better ability to digest their food, they feel better, it's just a better experience. Eating doesn't become like a forced march through the hot jungles of Burma. In other words, you dread it because the consequences of eating are so terrible. Doesn't have to be that way.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering, you're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
Over the past 60 years, I have prescribed and been introduced to countless health therapies from around the world. I formulated MediC Plus, a natural remedy with high amounts of vitamin C and lysine for maintaining strong bones, cartilage, teeth, and gums, and aiding in collagen formation. Now in my 90s, MediC Plus is my insurance for the maintenance of good health. Make MediC Plus a part of your daily health routine too.
Available at health food stores and specialty pharmacies.
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement, or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
drugs.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Renew Life, the digestive care company, Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing, Greens Plus, superfood for super health, MediC Plus, for heart health and more, New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom, NeoCell, the true science of collagen, Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition, wherever and however you may be listening or watching and whatever you may be doing. And you can call 877-897-8255. Maybe you've been diagnosed with food intolerance. If you have and you'd like to talk about it and share with other listeners and viewers of the show, as well as myself and my guest, I'd be delighted to have you call. Sometimes people are reluctant to do that, but we can often learn a lot from people who have had the experience and can give a firsthand account of what it's like and what they did that worked, didn't work, and so on. 877-897-8255. And Hamilton Cavanella is my guest educator for Enzymatica. So I often say on this show, and I've said it many times over the years, Hamilton, that your digestive health serves as the foundation to your overall health. If something goes amiss with your digestive system and the food cannot be properly digested and then absorbed through the small intestine, you got a problem. But you don't need to be a nutritionist or a dietitian or gone to Harvard or any other place to figure that out. Although there are many people, I dare say, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of people around the world walking around with digestive conditions and disorders and not knowing what to do or what's going on, just suffering. Hopefully the show tries to illuminate a little bit and educate so people don't have to do that. Nevertheless, there's a trio of things I always recommend for people. Take your probiotics, make sure you get enough fiber, and make sure you do some digestive enzymes. Those three things in combination can serve you very well. So digestive enzymes, I think, are an enzyme therapy is a longstanding tradition in the world of natural health and medicine, naturopathic medicine. So at Enzymedica, if we have somebody that's new to the world of enzymes here, so to speak, is there a product that they can start off with?
Absolutely. A product that was kind of inspired, again, from our work so close with the autism community, is called Digest Spectrum. Digest Spectrum is a product, a kind of medium strength formula, full spectrum. So it will cover, you know, like we talked about, your proteins, fats, and carbohydrates, so those main foods. But it also has enzymes to support the most common intolerances, which are, you know, gluten, dairy. And I mentioned dairy because some people think it's just a lactose issue that's causing them not to be mm-hmm. able to consume dairy. But casein is another big culprit, mm-hmm. that dairy protein, or it could mm-hmm. be the dairy fat. Mm-hmm. It covers phenols. So it covers a wide gamma of different common food intolerances. And again, you take it right before the meal.
It's called Digest Spectrum.
Correct.
In this somewhat dated article that I alluded to earlier and referenced, Food Intolerance in Humans by Herman and Hagler, two MDs. It was written in 1979. I found it real instructive, Hamilton. They talked about, and we were talking about lactose. Of course, that is a particular food intolerance that relates to carbohydrate. And they had this one portion of the paper where they were talking about carbohydrate-induced food intolerance. Let me just mention some of these to you and see if this rings a bell. They talked about a glucose-galactose intolerance. They talked about a lactose intolerance, sucrose-fructose intolerance, a galactose intolerance, a starch, generally starch intolerance, and several others. So they zeroed in just on this one portion of the paper on the carbohydrate. And this is interesting. You know, you have monosaccharides, disaccharides, the monosaccharides, fructose, glucose, and galactose, right? Disaccharides, sucrose, lactose, and maltose, right? Those are disaccharides. All sugars are built on those monosaccharides. They end up with these polysaccharides. So if you have an issue with some of these monosaccharides like glucose, fructose, and galactose, you got an issue. Now, some of these intolerances were associated with infancy and so on. I won't get into all the details. My point is everybody's familiar with lactose intolerance, but there are you got those macronutrients, carbohydrate, protein, and fat. The odds are good that you could have intolerances in all three categories, right?
Absolutely.
And not know it.
Absolutely.
And taking digestive enzymes, like this product, Digest Spectrum, would cover, it's sort of like covering the spectrum, if you will, right?
Absolutely. And we have others that are a little bit more specific. For example, if your trouble is more dairy, you know, I'm okay with gluten, but dairy, oh my gosh, dairy just kills me. Well, we make a product which is called Lacto. Lacto has a very high amount, again, of that enzyme lactase, has a very high amount of a protease blend to help with the casein or any other protein in the milk. It's got a high amount of lipase, which helps with the fats that also sometimes give trouble to individuals, along with other amylases to help with all those little other individual sugars in the dairy.
When you eat, if you were to eat a piece of bread, your salivary glands are going to secrete an enzyme called salivary amylase in the mouth. It doesn't stay in your mouth very long because people don't usually chew their food very long, so it doesn't have a real chance to do its work there. Then you have pancreatic amylase, which will be released by the pancreas a little later on in the digestive process. But these enzymes are in play throughout the digestive tract. It's interesting to track them through the tract and see where they come into play. And it's so intricate and elegant the way this all works. On one hand, once you see it and see the big picture, say, oh, yeah, I get this, it's relative. But it really is complicated, and a lot of things can go wrong along the way, genetically, environmentally, and, you know, aging being what it is. So it might be a good idea at any age to be taking these digestive enzymes. I have people that swear by it. They would not go a day, and they take it before every meal. Every meal, Hamilton.
And that's the idea. You want to be proactive. Again, there's so many different things in food that we may not even be sure you're having trouble with. So by taking the enzyme with each meal, you're kind of just covering your bases with all the different foods.
Tell you how complicated and intricate this can get. There's an amino acid induced in food intolerance. It's called Hartnup disease. I never heard of it. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
Yeah. So around here, we push ourselves. I never heard of that disease. It's spelled Hartnup, Hartnup disease. You want to know what that is? That's an intolerance to tryptophan. Who knew? As I'm learning about this, I'm starting to see, you know what? I'm surprised everybody doesn't have a food intolerance, given how many amino acids, all the different carbohydrates that are out there. Wow. We'll have the LTN health question when we come back.
Did you know that the most common form of calcium supplement today is calcium carbonate, also known as limestone? You don't eat rocks as part of your balanced diet, so why would you choose to supplement your bone health nutritional needs with limestone? Our bodies understand and seek whole food sources of nutrition. New Chapter is proud to deliver Bone Strength Take Care, a calcium complex that delivers key bone health nutrients in the form of whole food, not rocks. Bone Strength Take Care also delivers key bone nourishing nutrients, including vitamins D3 and K2. Vitamin K2 is of critical importance as it ensures calcium is placed in the bone where it's needed and stays out of the arteries where it's not. Discover for yourself the whole food bone health alternative to rocks. Bone Strength Take Care, the best-selling natural bone health supplement in America. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
As a family-owned company since 1968, Now Foods has spent the last 46 years building a legacy in the natural health industry as a trusted leader. Now provides a comprehensive approach to wellness by offering more than 1,400 high-quality health foods, supplements, sports nutrition, and personal care products at an affordable price. Now believes that natural is better. They don't use artificial colors, flavors, or sweeteners, and they offer many vegetarian, organic, and gluten-free products. Their foods are all non-GMO. Since their beginning, Now has grown to become an award-winning leader in the natural health industry. But one thing has never changed: their commitment to providing the highest quality products at the best value to empower people to lead healthier lives. High quality doesn't have to mean high price. From essential oils to amino acids, multivitamins to natural sweeteners, Now has you covered. To find a store near you that carries Now products, or for more information, visit nowfoods.com. That's nowfoods.com.
Aloha, I'm with pro triathlete Tim Marr. Tim, why is bioastin an important part of your training?
Bioastin is the strongest natural antioxidant fighting inflammation associated with hard training. It helps me get up day to day and put in the hard work without feeling sore and fatigued. I bounce back quicker and stronger. It also helps fight the elements from sun exposure, which is unavoidable when training for a triathlon.
Thanks, Tim. Make bioastin a part of your active and healthy lifestyle today. Aloha, Tim Marr. As a professional triathlete, training is important. How does bioastin help?
In triathlons, the last leg is always the run, which creates extra stress in the body because of all the tired pounding on pavement. Bioastin's main ingredient is astaxanthin, which fights free radical damage in the body while fighting oxidation. With high volume and long hours of training, recovery is such an important aspect, and bioastin helps me achieve a top-level performance.
Thanks, Tim. Make bioastin a part of your active and healthy lifestyle today.
Is your skin showing signs of aging? Do you want hair with more body and stronger nails?
Add NeoCell's Super Collagen Plus C to your daily routine to help you regain your youthful, vibrant appearance. Collagen is the body's key structural protein, and it is critical to the elasticity and strength of connective tissues like skin, ligaments, and tendons. Recent clinical studies suggest that supplementing with collagen may reduce wrinkles and increase the firmness of your skin, improve the thickness of your hair, and strengthen your nails. Previously, medical studies also show a wide range of benefits from collagen supplements that may help with your joint pain, bone strength, and exercise recovery. NeoCell's Super Collagen Plus C provides 100% pure collagen that's hydrolyzed for maximum absorption. Results are felt and seen within weeks. Super Collagen Plus C promotes a healthy body by providing specialized nutritional support to help fight the effects of aging. NeoCell's Super Collagen Plus C products are available everywhere fine nutritional supplements are sold.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss, or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted Best Independent Chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine, Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Canavest, from seed to shelf. Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition. Kyolic, aging makes the finest garlic truly odorless. Jaro Formulas, superior nutrition and formulation. Natural Factors, where great health begins. NZ Medica, the enzyme experts. Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Here's the LTN health question of the day. Earlier in the show, I reported on a story where a parent, a mom, took her 16-year-old boy, who was 60 pounds overweight, into a clinic. And the dietitian working in the clinic gave some advice to the parent. And the advice was, you know, your boy probably shouldn't be eating Chip Ahoy cookies. And the mother said, quote, "I can't believe you're telling me I can't buy Chip Ahoy cookies," close quote. So said the mother. Here's the health question for today. What was the mother's profession? Was she A, a nurse, B, a police officer, or C, a personal trainer? What was the mother's profession? Was she a nurse, a police officer, or a personal trainer? If you have the right answer, you'll win a $25 supplement gift card. You know you're looking for an odd answer, right? So you know me. And I've reported on stories similar to this where parents are in denial about their child's overweight or obesity problem. And it's a complicated issue. It's very complicated. And it takes sometimes more than an internist, you know, a weight loss specialist. Sometimes it may even take some therapy to sort it all out. And these studies, when you interview parents and the child is clearly obese and the parent doesn't recognize it, wow. You understand the implications of that. So what was the profession of this mom who said to the nurse, or who said to the dietitian, little hint, "I can't believe you're telling me I can't buy Chip Ahoy cookies." 877-897-8255. I don't think I've eaten chocolate chip cookie. Have you eaten Chip Ahoy's? Are they that good?
They're the little Keebler elves. They're kind of tasty.
Are they? I can make nutritional sin on the side while you're taking your digestive enzymes. So we mentioned only two products. I didn't have you come on here today to, you know, spend an hour and a half with us to just sell product, and because you want to educate people, right?
Absolutely.
And we're going to have you come back, but you only mentioned two products: Digest Spectrum, which is a general sort of all-purpose sort of digestive product. I had some samples of the product. I gave them to somebody I know, profusely thanked me.
Nice.
I said, I have just the recommendation for you. I happen to have that bottle, and I said, here, so it's yours. I said, no. You take it. I want you to try it. I have some others I'm taking. It'll be fine. Thank me profusely. Worked. Then you mentioned Lacto, which is for people who have lactose intolerance. Is there another good?
Absolutely. There's a few others. We have Glutenease and Glutenease 2X, obviously, for gluten sensitivities, which could be a great add-on for any other product. We have Phenol Jest, which
What's
is
that?
For phenols. People that have trouble with that type of carbohydrate, which is found in many of the darker fruits, darker berries, blueberries, red apples, watermelon, and such. There's an attachment of phenol. Again, sensitivity we kind of discovered in the autism community. Doesn't get digested properly, a certain carbohydrate, and that phenol triggers a digestive response. So it uses an enzyme, high amount of an enzyme called xylanase, to help break that bond and avoid the sensitivity. We have some for vegetarians, which is kind of a high amount of different amylases to help, you know, with
break
the cruciferous
carbohydrate.
The cruciferous vegetables, the broccoli, the cauliflower, the beans,
the starches,
etc.
Mm-hmm.
Correct. So we have different, you know, products specific for different people.
You have enzymes for cookies, crackers, cakes, chips, cupcakes. You have enzymes for that?
No, that's duct tape.
Let's go to Doylestown. Amy, welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Where's Doylestown, Amy?
Doylestown?
Yeah.
It's close to Lambsdale.
Oh, is it really now? And yes. How far are you from Philadelphia?
About 30, 35 miles.
Okay.
Philadelphia.
Yeah, stone's throw, not that far away. How are you doing today?
Good, how are you?
Good, thanks for asking. So, this mom that went into this clinic and talked to the dietitian, and the dietitian said, "Your son's 60 pounds overweight, madam. You know, you're gonna have to do something here. Maybe you shouldn't have the Chip Ahoy cookies served up to the boy." And the mom says, "I can't believe you're telling me I can't buy Chip Ahoy cookies." That mom, was she a nurse? Was she a police officer? Or was she a personal trainer?
I would say nurse.
You're exactly right. She was a nurse, and she's.
Unbelievable.
Makes you laugh, right? I mean, you say, what?
Really?
Whiplash. What? how could you not know? You went to nursing school.
Exactly.
Yeah. So we're delighted that you won. Congratulations. And we're very thankful that you listened to the show in Doylestown, too.
Well, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy it.
Thank you. Yeah. So the show, I don't know if you know Hamilton, but the show is syndicated across the U.S., we just added Atlanta. This week.
Nice. Yeah.
WWWE 1100 AM. And I'm doing that without notes. So a lot of people will hear this message today. I know there's more than a few that are saying, "Oh yeah, now I understand what's going on." So you can have the food intolerance, but you don't have to suffer. You can get your digestive enzymes from Enzymedica. Website that folks can go to.
www.enzymedica.com.
Spell that for them.
E-N-Z-Y, M as in Mary, E, D as in David, I-C-A.
E-N-Z-Y, then Medica. Enzymedica. I say Enzymedica. How do you all say it?
Enzymedica.
Enzymedica. Enzymedica. There you go. It's a lot of fun having you on today.
Thank you.
And you're now a movie star. Your wife will have this tape. As people know, the show does stream, and the shows are on demand. If you go to letstalknutrition.com, You'll see the video is on demand right on the homepage. The audio portion is on demand under a link called Show Schedule. And they tell me in the office at around 11 o'clock they'll have that LTN logo up. You can get that. Go to the Let's Talk Nutrition Facebook page. Like the page. Identify the name of the company with the logo. Send a message using Facebook, and you'll win a product from that company. In the meanwhile, take care of yourself, because your health is your wealth, and your health is the wealth of those that care about and love you.
Hi, I'm Kate. I try to eat a healthy